Hi, you guys. I'm Dr. Bree from Femme Fusion Fitness, which is, as you may know, your home for core and pelvic floor friendly fitness and women's health information. I'm going to share some issues that I deal with personally that can, if you're dealing with them too, actually hinder your progress with prolapse recovery or can make you feel like you're going backwards. So this is from personal experience. As you may know, I have had issues with prolapse myself. I developed a mild prolapse after the birth of my son. Now that was 10 years ago, and thankfully I was able to heal my prolapse with the help of specific exercises and lifestyle changes, and I share a lot of what I did in my Lift Pelvic Organ Support series, which I will put a link to that series, it's free, in the video notes. Anyway, so I feel like over the last 10 years, I have really, I don't consider myself to have prolapse anymore, so I'm thrilled about that. However, I will say that there are certain times when I am like, oh my gosh, I'm going back. I feel this sensation, this heaviness, and the feeling, that prolapse feeling, like there's something kind of in the way down there. It feels like it comes back. And I want to tell you why this occurs, even despite doing safe exercises that are safe for my pelvic floor, safe for my core, even despite all of the right posture tips and despite transitioning correctly and doing everything right, I can have this happen. And when I notice that it happens, it's because usually there's two things going on. One is that I'm pushing to pee more often, and also I'm constipated. So this happens to me. I'll tell you that the main time that this happens to me is when I'm under periods of stress, when I'm feeling very stressed out, when I'm feeling like I'm in a rush all the time. That often gets me in this zone where, even though I know better, I will push to get my pee out faster because I feel like I need to hurry so fast. I need to do everything I can to just go, go, go fast. Now, unfortunately, in times when I'm stressed out, I usually also tend to get a little stopped up and constipated. Now, if you think about it, pushing to pee, of course, that puts a lot of downward pressure on your pelvic organs. And when you're constipated, you're all full in this area. And that also puts pressure on your organs. Not only that, just the constant pressure of your full bowels pressing down on everything. But you also, when you do try to go to the bathroom, you kind of strain, or you're at risk for straining and pushing more than maybe you normally would if things were flowing more smoothly. So unfortunately, like I said, this all kind of ties together. I tend to get stressed, which makes me constipated and push to pee because I'm in a hurry. And another time that this tends to happen more often is kind of as a cruel twist of ironic nature. It often happens when I am in my premenstrual phase, when I am already at risk for being a little more moody, a little more anxious, a little more stressed out before I have my period. Now, during that time, your uterus is also a little more full at that time. So if you still have a uterus, if you have not had a hysterectomy and you're still menstruating, you are potentially going to see naturally just a change in your feeling of heaviness in the pelvic area throughout your menstrual cycle. And it will likely feel heavier and lower when you're close to having your period. So it's like this perfect storm. You're stressed, you're premenstrual, you're moody, your period or your uterus is already kind of in a different position than other times of the month, and you're constipated and you're pushing to pee. Like I said, perfect storm for that feeling of, oh my gosh, everything is going backwards. My prolapse is coming back. So I want to share with you some things that I do, and I'm just going to kind of quickly go through these tips when this is the situation that I'm in. So first of all, I have dealt with constipation my entire life, so I've got a lot of tricks. The main thing that I want to share first is that everyone is different, and tricks are not that work for me are not necessarily going to work for you. So this is just what works for me. But first of all, warm water, not cold. So skip the cold water, keep your water lukewarm, room temperature, or even warm. And you know, definitely drink a lot. Another one is abdominal massage, and I like to do this when I first wake up in the morning. And I used to do it by just doing a circular motion, going up the right side of my colon, this is my right side right now, going up and then across and then down, which follows the pattern of the ascending colon, the transverse colon, and the descending colon. I used to just do little circular motions, but I have a new way, which I love even better. What you do is you put your fingers, and I'm gonna probably describe this further in another video, so I won't go too far into depth, but you put your fingers right to the sides of your belly button. So on the left side, the bottom, the right side, and then the top. And what you do is you press into these areas, these quadrants, right around your belly button while you do deep core breathing. So every time you exhale, you push down gently. It's not like a hard push, but you just gently follow the exhale and push down into your belly tissues. And so you do that about three times, about three breaths in each quadrant, the left side, the bottom, the right side, and the top of your navel area, your belly button area. And then you go in the spaces between, so kind of the diagonal, so just right in this in the spaces that you haven't actually touched yet. So you do that, and then you do a little massage all the way around your colon, like I mentioned before. And I have had great success with that. Again, best done on an empty stomach, usually first thing in the morning. So warm water, the abdominal massage, and then I love to walk. I go for a nice 30, 45 minute walk, and that usually stirs things up. I also like to lie on my belly to work. So I find that to read or to even type on my laptop, if I lie on my belly, that pressure really helps to stimulate the bowels, and it's safe. As long as you're not really, you know, as long as you're not uncomfortable. You don't want to do anything that makes you feel nauseous or uncomfortable in any way, but for me, it's very stimulating and I love that trick. The other thing is, for me, work actually makes me very relaxed. I find that when I'm doing just a kind of rote, just an easy task, but a work-related task where I'm not super stimulated by new information, it's something I know how to do, like just checking and responding to emails or writing a blog post, something that's not super, super stressful. It's just sort of relaxing and chill, and I feel like I can be creative and kind of get into the flow of it. That really helps me relax and be able to then have a bowel movement. Let me make sure I'm not forgetting anything. Second cup. I am not above a second cup of coffee. I have coffee every morning. I love coffee. But, you know, sometimes many people will use coffee as a laxative, a stimulant to get things moving. And I'm not going to lie. It helps me too. But sometimes even that first cup of coffee does not do anything and I'm just stuck. And so in that case, every once in a while, I will have a second cup after I've done some of the tricks that I just mentioned, because, you know, you really want to kind of get things going. And then if you have that second cup, assuming, you know, again, that you're not averse to caffeine, that you don't have reactions to excessive caffeine, then it can be very stimulating and can really help you after you've done those other tricks to get things going. The other one is anxiety, I've already mentioned. When you're stressed out and up here like this, you need to calm the system down. So I love to use essential oils such as lavender, clary sage, cedarwood, and cypress. Those are all, for me, very calming, soothing oils. I use them in the diffuser or just smell them right out of the palm of my hand or apply them topically with a carrier oil. And interestingly, cypress is the oil of flow. And so, hey, maybe that's one reason it helps me too. I think the last thing that I have to share with you is that having moments and in time where I am more constipated reminds me that my supplements are actually very important for me. I really benefit from using a digestive enzyme with my meals. I use one called Terrazyme, and I also benefit from the occasional use of a supplement called Zendocrine Detoxification Complex, which I happen to love. It really helps me out. Also magnesium, I didn't mention that one. Magnesium is a great supplement to help with flow. And so the supplements are very, very helpful. A last resort would be a colon cleanser type of supplement that's more hardcore. Those are something that you don't necessarily want to get involved with. They can be pretty harsh on your system. So that's all about constipation. I mean, know that this will pass, but know that you really do need to take these steps if you can, without stressing about it, but take these steps to help get things moving so that you don't have to strain when you're having a bowel movement and so that you're not getting too full and impacted in the bowel area, because that really will prevent you from having the smooth and easy recovery with your prolapse that you want to, and it can make you feel like you're going backwards in your recovery. The other aspect of this whole thing was pushing to pee, so don't push to pee. Take your time, sit down. This takes willpower to remember, oh my gosh, I actually can spare 30 seconds of my life to just sit and pee in a relaxed fashion. It doesn't need to get done in 7 seconds. So, you know, it's a work in progress for me too, I have to fully admit. I push to pee more often than I would like, and this is super common for women and people who have careers that are especially service oriented, like nurses and teachers and doctors. You know, you're in a role where you have to get back to your patients, you have to get back to your students. I understand, but at the same time, truly, in most cases, the world won't end. Well, probably in all cases, the world won't end, but in most cases, it's gonna be okay if you take a few extra seconds to just let it all come out in a relaxed fashion. Because truly, these things that you do every day, peeing, pooping, that kind of thing, it adds up, and it can definitely hinder your progress in prolapse recovery, or it can even make prolapse progress and get worse. So take this stuff seriously, it's important, and I hope these tips have helped you. Again, about the constipation, it was warm water, the belly massage, the four quadrants around your belly button with the breathing. So you take 3 deep breaths, pressing down with the exhale in each quadrant, and then you go in the spaces between, and then you do the full abdominal massage circle. So good. And then lying on your belly, maybe reading or doing some work on a computer, whatever makes you feel relaxed, maybe do a crossword puzzle, walking, second cup of coffee sometimes, take your supplements, your digestive enzymes, use a cleansing aid as a last resort, and maybe try out some essential oils if that helps you relax and let go. So I hope this has helped you, and this is a super real topic and super important for us to start discussing and sharing. If you have any tips that work for you, please let me know in the comments. I love hearing from you guys, and this is a really maybe embarrassing topic for you to share about, but at the same time, I mean, come on, like woman to woman, friend to friend here, we've got to talk about this stuff because this affects so many people. And you could actually maybe share something that would help a sister of ours, you know, a sister in the FemFusion community who needs a little support and a little help in the constipation realm. And also remember, don't push to pee. Subscribe to my channel if you like this information, and if it's something that really speaks to you and it has helped you in your life, give this video a thumbs up. And until next time, remember, eat clean, move every day, and you will shine brighter. Thanks for watching.